Hello, this is Lauren again from the web team. In the last video, I showed you how to log into your site and add some basic content. In this video, I'll show you how to add links to that content, and then in another video, we will go over adding images. To get started, make sure you're logged into your site, and I can see that I am logged in because I have the administration toolbar up here. And to find the content that I want to add links to, I'm just going to click on this content button, and Drupal will give me a list of the content that has been created thus far on my website. So I want to add links to the academic programs page, which is a basic page I created in the last video. So I'm going to click here and then click on this edit tab. So I'm looking for a place to add a link, and I'm going to type in some text. I think it would be great to have a link to UGA's graduate school under this how to apply to the graduate school subsection. So I'm going to type in some text. Click here to visit the graduate school main site. And then I'm going to select the text that I want hyperlinked. And one thing I'm not going to do is I'm not going to select just click here, because that makes the link non-specific, and folks with disabilities who are using screen readers will not be able to interpret click here if it's isolated. So I actually want to be specific and either select graduate school main site or the whole thing, and I'm going to select all of it. And then to add a link, I'm going to look for the link icon, and it's just this little globe with a chain on it. And when I mouse over, it says link. And a pop-up will come up, and a place to put the URL or address. So I know the location of the graduate school site is www.grad.uga.edu. I click OK, and now that area is hyperlinked. So I'm going to save that and test out my link to make sure that it works. So I've saved the page. I scroll down. There's that link that I added. And when I click on it, it takes me to the graduate school. So that works. Always check your links, because typos happen to us all. So I've shown you how to add a link to an external site. What if you want to provide a link to a page that you've created on your site? We can definitely do that. In fact, I think it would be great if I had a link to my department's research under graduate programs. So I'm going to put a link there to our research. And right now we do have a research tab with some placeholder text there, and I can provide a link to that. So before I go back into editing academic programs, I want to figure out where that research page or content is located. What is the address, the URL for that? The simplest way to figure that out is actually just by clicking on it. So I click on the research tab, and I notice that in the address bar it provides a location of /research. Really simple. You can either remember that or you can copy that information. Now I only want to copy the information from the slash after, because I don't want to copy any of this information, because when my site goes live, that information will change. My site will not be located at CMS host 3. It will be located at like classics.uga.edu or cellbio.uga.edu. So I only need from slash forward. And I'm copying that, and I'm going to go back to my academic programs page by clicking on content. And now I'm going to add a link. So I want to type in some text, and again, it's going to be kind of specific text. So I'm going to say, maybe I have a sentence that says, "We have many research opportunities in this department." So I can hyperlink research opportunities, or you know what, even just research. Research is specific enough. Again, I go to that icon, click on it, and paste the URL to my page. Do not forget to include that slash, otherwise your link will not work. So I'm going to hit OK. I see that text has been linked. I'm going to save it and test it out. So I've saved my page and I'm looking for that link I added. There it is, research. And when I click on research, it takes me to the research tab. So my link works. Now I'm going to show you how to add images to your basic pages, and that's actually coming up in the next video.